show love, love must rule. Yes. A great servant of God said, let love what? Lead. Hallelujah. A great servant of God who passed on to glory, he taught us, he said, let love what? Lead. He was a preacher of love. He liked to preach about love. I think he's the only prophet I've seen that preaches love to the core. Hallelujah. And that prophet said, me, I'm not a preacher of love, who? This prophet is a preacher of love. Or me, I am not a preacher of what? Of love. So some prophets will tell you like that. But we must not preach love. Hallelujah. It is true that all prophets cannot be the same, but no matter the doctrine we are preaching, we must all preach what? Love. Love must be part of our message. But one thing you must know, every prophet has their own what? Design. Hallelujah. Can I tell you something? Okay, I am led to say this, and the Spirit of God is leading me now. The next intercessor of Prophet TB Joshua, that's the one who to succeed him. Those of you, if you watch my video, you realize that I've talked about who a general is. I think I've been able to open the understanding of people. His next intercessor, the one should not expect that he will be like him. Hallelujah. That is, the one should not expect he will be like him with his speech or the way he talks. No. That's why when you read your Bible, every general, Moses was a general. Now, when Moses was leading, you will see that when Joshua took over, Joshua was not like Moses. Was he like Moses? Now, after Joshua, who was the next general? Who? You see, generals like Isaiah came up. Now, was Isaiah what's the name? Joshua. No. When you look at Samuel, was Samuel like Joshua? No. You see them. Some of these prophets, some of them were preach some, okay. Someone like Joshua was preaching brimstone and fire. Hallelujah. Amen. Because he was wielding a sword. When you look at Elijah, Elijah was a general that was wielding a very deadly sword. Any enemy of God, you should just bring them down. Don't want to know. Abby? That was Elijah. I don't want to know. Any enemy of God will bring them down. Now, God Almighty sent generals at different points in time. Now, if there is chaos in the land at certain time, and what God needs is fire, he will send a general that can wield fire. Now, if what is happening in the world at that time, God needs love, he will send a general that needs to preach that love. Hello? Amen. So people need to understand this. His next intercessor is not someone that will preach like him. That's what people need to know. I've been telling people this. In 2012, the Lord revealed to me that Prophet TB Joshua was going to pass on. I've been telling people this, but people were insulting me. They said, you don't like better thing. Come on, you are a bad person. You are decent. I was like, how am I a bad person? I'm telling you what God has revealed to me. That even for your information, he's using extra time. He's taking the time of the next general. He's supposed to have gone. I was telling people. People say, this person, you are a bad person. I think at the point that they told him, they said, this is what one small girl was saying. He didn't say anything. I said, why would he say anything? Because he knows I'm saying the truth. It is you that don't know, that will abuse me. Hallelujah. Amen. Because when you follow this ministry, it is true we are at the back here. But when you follow this ministry, you see that there are so many antecedents. I remember when Prophet TB Joshua died, a month before he passed on, I traveled down. Because not too long, a few years ago, I came down to Accra. I traveled down, I went to see him. Am I going to see him? I know that he will soon pass on. Let me quickly see him. It's only proper. When you know a general is leaving, quickly run down to see him before he goes. I went down to see him and I saw him. I said, please, I want to see our daddy in the Lord. I saw him at the prayer mountain. He was putting on his blue garment at the prayer mountain. He has just finished attending to partners at the mountain. And I remember his words to me. He said, how are you? I said, fine, sir. He said, I see what God is using you to do. Wow, that's cool. Keep it up. I watch you. I'm watching you. I watch you on the internet. I watch you. And he was like, is it now you're supposed to come to me? Hallelujah. I saw him. I said, sir, I said, daddy, you know what he's going to. I said, no, don't worry, I know. Okay, no problem. I said, thank you, sir. Hallelujah. So there is need. So a month before he passed, after coming back to Abba, just a few weeks later, he passed on. And some people were saying that it's not supposed to be. And I'll be like, what is it not supposed to be? Someone that came to fulfill a mandate on earth. Ha! I told him, I said, if they people don't understand things of the spirit, though, generals don't used to last for. Don't expect a general to live for 70 years. Don't expect it. So this should be a lesson to the world now. A general does not live for long. They are only here to fulfill a specific mandate. Once they fulfill it, God will call them home. They come back, let the next person enter. And the next person has another purpose for what? To fulfill. That's what the world needs to know. And the last time, let me say this. I'm saying this because I'm not saying this out of, how will I put it? Out of hatred or whatever. It's out of love. I have related with the ministry of Fertibi Joshua. I'm saying this for the first time. Some people will say, I gave a message of prophecy the last time. Some people will say, I want to use him to grow. And I begin to wonder. I came from Lagos to Abba. Nobody knew I was from synagogue. It's just now people are knowing. Because I am not interested in using somebody's glory to shine. I'm not interested in that. I know what God has given me. Me, I want to build from the scratch. If I want to use him to shine, it does not take me when I came to Abba, I'll just put the banner everywhere. I'll put my picture and put Fertibi Joshua's picture that I am from him. But the Lord told me, don't do that. So I want you to have first-hand ministry experience. Don't let people know you are from synagogue. Don't tell them. Because if you let them know, you will only be building on his glory, on his... So don't do that. You have to have first-class ministry experience. You have to know what it is when people fight you. You have to know when attacks come. You have to understand this. That's what the Lord told me. Mind you, that is not to say that others who are doing that, I'm not castigating them. It's fine. But I'm just saying my own kind of calling. The Lord stopped me. So people who are saying, now, why talking now? What is it to shine? There's nothing to shine. But one thing is certain. When the Lord gives us a message, we have to speak. The last time before the Squan opened service, I gave a warning. I said, Squan is not meant to open service. That was why I took my time here at the altar. I explained who a general is. In fact, I took my time. Not everybody will understand this. Only those who are spiritually inclined. Now, when somebody who knows the Spirit is telling you, can I say something? You cannot sympathize more than the Holy Spirit. Hello? You cannot what? What are the what? Holy Spirit. What do you mean? God forbid. Even some people will say you are stupid. So that God will stand with God. Can you imagine? Can you love more than God? Eh? No. Can you love more than God? Can you sympathize more than Jesus? No. Jesus that called him, that is the Father of that, is telling you that that place, with nothing should go on there, no service. The Lord is giving a form of how the place should run now. And people are saying, God, but I begin to wonder, and these people who are talking, please, can you take your time? Go and fast. Go and pray. Give yourself devotion to God and let God open your eyes. When God opens your eyes, you will not say what you are saying. You cannot sympathize more than the what? The Holy Spirit. You cannot. You cannot. Look, I can't love more than God. Why would I love more than God? Am I the embodiment of love? God is the embodiment of love. So it is the love from him that we take. So you can't love more than God. That's why the scripture says God is good. All the what? That is, even if God takes some decision that might not favor you, God is good in that what? In that decision. Even if it does not favor you. As I said, he is good all the world, all the time. So what I'm saying this is that I'm giving this final warning. Final warning. And I want to plead with Mommy Evelyn Joshua. Yes, we it looks as if we are the backyard now. We may not have the so much resources now to reach where we're supposed to reach, but we know in the distant future we are going to reach unreachable places. Now I want to give a final warning. Please, you people have started the service, but the Lord has revealed to me I'm seeing a disaster coming, and it's very close. It's too close. Why I am saying this is because my pain will be that what Prophet T.B. Joshua has labored for and everything comes crumbling. Because a general what he has built is supposed to last from generation to what? To generation. Don't build on, for heaven's sake, this is a general. You can't, what other record do you want to place down? You have no record to place down. Mm-mm. You have no record. I've always said this. And I want to plead with our mommy. Please, mommy, don't allow people around you to talk to you with their sweet mouths. Those that God have really sent to you, they will talk to you and you will hate those, or you will feel somehow towards those people that really love you. I am one of those that love you and pray for you all the time. That is why God is giving us this message. But those people around you who are only there to eat the money, then those whom God has sent, they will tell you, say, don't mind them. It's not serious. It's not serious. Because they are only there to eat what? Money. We are not there for the money. We are there for truth. Because the disaster I am seeing that is coming, I am seeing the sword is already raised. And this disaster is deadly. I gave this prophecy before we started service. The hand is already raised to start causing destruction. Please. I would have not said this because people will say I'm using the what is the glory to shine. What is there to shine about this message? Me, that I'm just starting ministry. Don't you know that this message does not come to pass? Don't you know I'm also putting my calling on the line because I'm just starting. But we are sure. That is why if you check the antecedents of my messages, you will see that there is no word of prophecy the Lord gave me that has not come to pass. I stood here on the altar 2020 last year. As I pray for UK, I'm seeing a train accident. People are looking at me. Say, what is she saying? Small girl. I stood there, I said, pray, I'm seeing Nnamdi Kanu being recaptured. You are looking. I'm small here, but I'm the only one prophesying this. No other one is prophesying. You're a big pastor, no one is prophesying this. No one. A lot of prophecy. I talked about 2 years before coronavirus came out. I said, I'm seeing a deadly sickness that is going to visit the earth very soon. I said, everyone should pray. You are looking at me. So many, uncountable, I cannot say. A lot. So if all these prophecies from the beginning have been coming to pass, is it this one that will not come to pass? Please, oh, I am saying this out of love. Please, a general, the work he has done is meant to be preserved. And the way you are going about it, it will lead to destruction. I saw in the spirit Prophet T.B. Joshua moving around the church in the synagogue. He is not happy. He's moving around. His spirit is not at rest. He's panting, moving around. Well, what do we do? What kind of people are these? I think I told them. Now, let me say this. I am saying this out of love. Can you bring out the last video? I want to beg the world. Go back to the last video of his record, where the day he passed on at the prayer mountain. Can you go back to that video and play it? Please, can you do that? Go back to the last video while on the prayer mountain he came out. Now while he came out, he never prayed for anyone that day. He never prayed for anyone that day. He just came out. And when he came out, he just said, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, please, can somebody tell me? Can you people please tell me? After here, no one should be coming here again. What we'll be doing is interactive prayer. He said, please, after today, he said, interactive what? God. He never did any prayer. He did not lay hand. He did not drop any anointing water or whatever. Nothing. He just came out with speed and said, after from here now, please, can someone tell me, why did I say after today? You will not gather here again. What you will be doing is interactive prayer. Can you please tell me? Then we were giving people the what? The mind to speak. After that, Prophet T.B. Joshua dropped the mic. You see him, he moved with speech. And he entered inside. Immediately he entered inside. He passed on. Oh my God. Please. I am begging. Mommy Evelyn, I'm begging. Mommy Sarah, I am begging. You know me. You know me very well. I am one of your daughters. You know me. You know me as Chidima.
You know me as. That is what you know me as. I want to beg. Please don't allow people around you to spoil your mind because they want to eat the money that has been labored for. They want to finish the money. Because that money of the synagogue will not last. Keep that money. Allow those of truth that God has sent to you, let them guide you. Let them guide you properly. May the Lord bless in Jesus' name. If you need more of my advice, there's some things I can't say on air. But this one, because the thing has, it has pinched me so much. Prophet Joshua will come to me and he will tell me, why don't you want to talk? Tell these people now. Tell them. And sometimes I'll be like, Daddy, but you would have to, I don't know. If I talk now, they say she has come again, that she's enemy of progress. But I will have to talk. You don't understand who a general is, but me, I know. I understand who the general. Please don't destroy the work of a general. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. The people of God finally.